Mike, as we all know him as Camby. I first met Mike a long time ago.
Well, I had known Nick through going to church, our local church, when we were young kids, but we didn't get to be closer friends until we were about in middle school, 6th or 7th grade.
Met Mike. I've known him for a while, but I didn't start hanging out with him until like 6th grade.
All of us came together at Eastview when we, became of age, started really becoming good friends with each other, and we were terrors at Eastview. I mean, me, Mike, Max.
Yeah, so me and Mike. Mike was smaller at the time. Well, he's still small, kind
of. We used to sneak out of our class early to run down the hall to play a little game we made up.
Mike put on the two backpacks on front and back, and then Max would always just push him into other people walking in the halls.
He would turn me into a human projectile, and he would launch me into younger kids and
knock people down, flip people over. It's fun.
I mean, nothing was really too bad. We just kept getting in trouble for some dumb shit.
One day they kept making announcements. Every morning, once again, every morning we go into the classroom, they'd make an announcement. They'd be like, whoever's peeing on the radiators, stop. We're going to catch you. We're going to get you.
I pissed on the radiators.
He was the kid that you really wouldn't think would do something, like, really bad.
Didn't even know, no one knew. That was it.
We never even knew that it was this kid Pete who did it, because he kept it completely to himself.
We were a little wild and crazy. We liked to fucking do some misbehaved stuff sometimes.
Max and Mike were always going around to the bathroom stalls in Eastview.
We conceived this idea that it would be hilarious if we took a bunch of tools, screwdrivers and wrenches, and
start unscrewing like all the bolts and nuts in the bathroom or whatever.
And, you know, see what would happen when somebody went in there. So we did it.
So someone would go into a stall or go into the bathroom, and then when they went to get out, they'd pull the handle.
That it would break when they touch it next.
So they would be trapped inside either the stall or the bathroom.
And they immediately suspected us because we were always the kids trying to do some stupid shit.
We almost got expelled actually, so it wasn't good, but it was funny as hell.
And we were like, nah, we don't know anything about it. What are you talking about?
Yeah, middle school was definitely when we all became friends. We had a crazy, crazy time in middle school.
You know, everyone seemed to just kind of mesh together.
When we got in trouble, we would always be, like, we were the craziest bunch of kids at Eastview.
Run it! Look at Camby!
Jess, be on. Are you jumping up, right? Yeah, jumping! Get ready! One! Two! Three!
Go!
We all shared like common interests, and like we like throughout our adolescence age we grew up together, and like going through like shit together or whatever like strengthened our relationship, and like we just kept hanging out.
I would say we definitely brought a lot of people together, kind of bridged things together. Bridge different groups of people together, you know, everybody in our same age group kind of all came to one because we are such a diverse group of people with many different interests and likes that we would meet other people, bring them into our group, and then just, so we had a really big group of friends, you know, like, because of that. You know, everybody started to do their own thing, you know, half of us went to college, the other half, you know, some of us joined the military, some of us did other things, you know, it was just another part of us growing up, you know.
When I think about why I joined the military and why I chose the Marine Corps, I always felt a sense of loyalty to other people.
We were just at home, and I was going to school. Mike wasn't doing anything.
And you put forward your best effort for the people next to you.
There was no one to my right or to my left saying, you know, get up, get up, get up, go to class, go to class.
When you grow with somebody, you feel that camaraderie, and just from like playing on like sports teams throughout like my young life and through high school, I wanted to continue that feeling, and I knew that the Marine Corps was a big part of teamwork.
Eventually he was supposed to leave in October, then eventually got moved to November, then eventually got moved to December, then he even got eventually moved to February, maybe even March.
You work your hardest every day for what it's worth.
I really started hanging out with Mike a lot more, and I really started to realize, you know, I want to follow my dream in life, you know? Like, what I wanted to do with my life is become a Marine.
What I felt was important in my own life, that you need to be close to the people you work with. And the Marine Corps is the number one, the absolute number one when it comes to coming together and working together as a team.
So me and Mike both shipped for boot camp on January 5th, 2009.
They just left, and it's like, damn, they weren't here no more.
It was pretty weird, actually. They've been talking about it. They were talking about it. Well, Mike was talking about it for a while.
Like, they were, those two I called, like, all the time, with a couple other people. And then, like, as soon as they left, it wasn't too many people that I really called. And, yeah, it was just, like, kind of lonely or whatever.
You realize how much you know, miss the people you're around when they're not there.
As far as Marine Corps boot camp is concerned, I have some great experiences. There are a lot of tough moments.
The drill instructors would break you down and sort of really mentally destroy you, physically destroy you, test your true abilities of who you were and how strong and how much heart you had.
And you're physically fatigued, but you just keep pushing on, and you know that the more you put into it is the more you get out.
Because when it really comes down to it, boot camp was 90% mental, 10% physical.
The mental toughness that you build, the mental strength that you gain, the confidence that Marine Corps boot camp instills in you is an amazing feeling. You want to strive to be the best every day, and you want to be better the next day. And that's what Marine Corps boot camp does to you. Makes you work your hardest every day.
I would have to say coming back home to White Plains was, it was almost like unbelievable at one point.
It was fantastic to come home and see all my friends and see all my family and to know how proud they were of me. And, you know, that makes you feel good. That makes you feel like more accomplished than when you began.
It was the same. As soon as they came back or whatever, like, they didn't really change. It's like we just picked up where we left off again.
As soon as I saw everybody again from back home, it was like, oh my God. I kind of didn't even, like, I was like, holy crap, this really happened. You know, I'm seeing my friends again.
When they came back, it was like, oh shit, like, we're happy to see you guys. You know, tell us, you just went through something that probably none of us are going to go through.
You go through this, such this climactic change in your own life that when you come back home, it's almost harder to adjust. It's harder to relax.
Really coming back was crazy, because tomorrow I'm leaving. I'm going back down to North Carolina, and I got to take that light switch, as our drill instructor used to say, take that light switch and flip it on and off and get out of this relaxed state of mind that I've been in for the past 10 days.
I mean, as open as I am to go back, like, I'm
never going back.
it's mad hard to, like, no lie, like, it's mad crazy, like a mental kind of stress that you've never felt before, like making the adjustment, like,
back
from
and forth.
Like, especially from boot camp back to, like, your, like, home life, you know? Like, it's mad crazy. Like, those first couple of days, like, I woke up and I was like, that first day, like, I slept in a hotel with my girlfriend. I woke up that morning, I was like, fuck. Like, I did not know where I was for, like,
you wake up mad early?
Not even, but, like, because we went to bed mad late, but, like, I woke up and, like, I was dazed with a slight headache, you know, the usual. You know, like,
you know, my parents raised me. My parents and my family, you know, they raised me to be part of who I am today. But the rest of that's accounted to my friends. You know, they kind of smoothed out all the rough edges. They, growing up, we've learned a lot from each other. You know, we all kind of experienced life together.
In some sense, people grow up with their family, you know, mother and father, teach them morals, teach them all these things, but me especially, and everybody else, all of our friends together, we grew up with each other.
Like, we'd get in trouble together or whatever. We'd, like, it's like part of sharing, like, common things. If you share something with someone, like, then you start, like, or like a bond with them, and like if you keep sharing with them, like it keeps getting stronger and stronger and stronger.
We molded ourselves into who we are. We respect each other and we know how each other think.
Simple words that we always come up to say to each other is family, loyalty, and respect.
You know, we were with each other constantly. They weren't just friends, they were kind of, you know, family. We were with each other constantly doing something. Everybody knew everybody's family. Everybody's family knew all the friends, everybody I was hanging out with, so.
It's almost like you might not see them for periods of time, but whenever you're with them, you feel like you're home, and you feel like they're your brother. They're your brother to your left and their brother to your right, and when you're just sitting there talking to them, it's like talking to family, not friends.
Hopefully we're gonna be keeping in touch for a really long time. And we're gonna be, you know, good friends for whatever to come.
No matter where I go and wherever, no matter where the Marine Corps is gonna take me, no matter where jobs are in the future gonna take me or wherever, just life is gonna take me down the past. Maybe I'll live in California, maybe I'll live over here, you know. You always know that you have your brothers, you have your family, you have your friends who are your family back home to always just talk to, rely on, and be there for you.
We know each other like to do, what we don't like to do, you know, what's you know, how to push each other's buttons just because we've hung out so many hours in a row, and you know, all those little things that add up that make us people. We all become each other because we know each other so well. Just another day living in New York, dealing with the jakes and the snakes. Feeling good today. We hear the rap, but we hear the